Hello, my name is Lenny Zeltzer. I'm one of the authors and instructors of Forensics 610, Reverse Engineering Malware. And it's my pleasure to tell you a little bit about this practical course, which covers malware analysis tools and techniques. It is such a relevant field nowadays. I started out in this industry at the time when the analysis of malicious software was considered such a niche area, but gone are those days. Nowadays, when you're dealing with a potential incident, very likely you will encounter some form of malware that you will need to examine. First of all, you might need to examine suspicious artifacts to determine could those represent the malicious tools that the adversary was using as part of the incident. You will need to look at a compiled Windows executable, perhaps, or at a malicious-looking Microsoft Office document and understand its capabilities so that you can best determine how did the adversary penetrate your defenses. What else was the attacker planning to do in your environment, and how might you best respond to the incident and get back into a normal business state? And that is what we focus on in this course, Forensics 610. Individuals who have taken this course have held a variety of positions within the world of information security. Some people focus specifically on incident response or perform forensic investigations. In those settings, they come across these suspicious artifacts that they really need to analyze quite closely. They might start out examining a malicious artifact using a fully automated malware analysis sandbox, but in many cases, these tools are limited regarding what they can provide to you. And so if the incident calls for a closer look at that suspicious file, you need to know how to take it apart in your own lab using the kinds of practical tools that we cover in this course. Now, many people who have attended this course were not specialists in incident response, but rather had a broader set of responsibilities related to defending the enterprise. And what a better way to understand how adversaries think so that you can protect your environment against them than to take apart the tools that they use to commit their crime. Security researchers, penetration testers similarly find it very useful to learn how to better think like the attacker by gaining inspiration and knowledge from reverse engineering the tools that attackers have used in the wild. And so this is what we do in this course. We look at lots of different real-world malware samples, and we discuss best ways to take them apart using a variety of techniques, which include behavioral analysis, static code-level analysis, and, of course, debugging. And in most cases, these techniques intermingle so that at the end of the course, you have a practical methodology and a variety of methods to bypass defenses that might be built into malware and to understand the capabilities of malicious code that you might need to analyze. Now, there's a lot to cover in the field of malware analysis and reverse engineering. And therefore, this course is split into 6 sections. We start out, of course, with some introductory materials. People who take this class come with various backgrounds. Some are stronger with the world of Microsoft Windows. Others feel more comfortable on Linux. Some people have done some assembly analysis before. Others are completely new to the world of assembly. And so we take some time to make sure that in the beginning of the course, we define a joint framework that all of us feel comfortable using moving forward. Having established that foundation, the future sections of the course deal with the more advanced topics. For instance, in section 2, we spend a lot of time looking at assembly instructions that you're most likely to see when analyzing malicious code. Learn how to interpret various constructs that will help you understand capabilities of malware with the help of tools such as a disassembler and a debugger. Then, we'll look at other forms of malware, including JavaScript or malicious document files, the types of techniques that you will need to have when analyzing not just compiled executables, but related technologies that are typically used as part of modern attacks. Then, we go deeper, because as you would expect, the complexity of the course increases as we go further along. This means that by section 4, we're covering relatively advanced malware samples, learning how to deal with packed executables and starting to think about methodologies for bypassing protections that might be built into the malware that you're trying to analyze. And really, by section 5, we're prepared to learn how to bypass a lot of these methods that attackers employ to slow us down and to bypass automated analysis solutions. So there's lots of examples in this course because that is the best way to learn. Certainly, you will cover a lot of foundational concepts, but much of the time is spent in the course in your hands-on lab where you apply these techniques so that by the end of Section 5, you feel pretty comfortable applying various methods related to behavioral analysis, code-level analysis, and other techniques to make sense of malicious software. But then there is Section 6, and Section 6 is special in that we spend our time playing a capture the flag tournament. It is not just so that you can earn points and win bragging rights. No, it is also an opportunity to learn through examining additional malware samples, as well as to start putting together those various discrete techniques that we may have covered earlier in the course. So this is really a capstone exercise that is a fantastic way to finish the course by both gaining the confidence that you know what to do once the course ends and also understanding how to handle those scenarios where maybe you don't know exactly what you're doing and you need to find your way to the solution nonetheless. So I hope you consider taking this course if you're looking to better understand how to analyze malware. It's just a fantastic skill set to be able to turn malware inside out. And if you're not sure what that really means, beyond the explanation that I just shared with you, take a look at the course website, sense.org/FOR610. There you will see a detailed outline, all the concepts explained to you in greater depth. And I hope that you will consider taking this course to help become a better malware analyst and a stronger security professional.